Good morning, students. As a part of the series of video lectures for the BCom first semester business organization subject in the unit 2, in the earlier classes we have covered the sole tradership, partnership, and to a major extent of the joint stock companies. In the joint stock companies, we have already learned about the definitions, the characteristics or features of joint stock company, the merits and demerits of the joint stock company. Today, we will go for a quick overview of the various types of companies generally being observed by us in the corporate sector. First one, it is a public limited company. And what is a public limited company? See, all these companies here given as types of companies have been given on the version of the way they have been formulated and they have been in function. So today we will go for the learning of the first one, public limited company. What is a public limited company? A public limited company is a company where the capital or the pool of shares of the capital, share capital, is being subscribed by the public. Means the total amount pool of the share capital has been invested in the shape of shares by the common public, or who are called as investors or the shareholders. The company which has issued the prospectus for acquiring the share capital to the public is denoted as public limited company. In the case of the public limited company, the minimum number of members is 7 and the maximum is unlimited. And there is a need on the part of the public limited company to show it as a limited company. Right? So when once it is a public limited company, it means that the company is subscribed its capital through the issue of prospectus towards the public, and the public contribution is there. So by default, the public limited company is accountable to the public of the country or public in general. So the public limited company is such a company where the share capital is being procured from the common public, common people. Right? Next one is private limited company. The private limited company is a company where the share capital has been subscribed by a very few members, mostly the promoters of the company belongs to either their personal or relatives or friends or groups. The minimum number of membership starts with 2 and the maximum is 50 in the case of the private limited company. And it is also essential here, a private limited company should not issue a prospectus for subscribing the share capital of the company. For example, in one case, if a private limited company has issued a prospectus, then what happens? Automatically, the private limited company will become a public limited company. Right? So, generally, the private limited company will not go for the issue of prospectus. The minimum number of members should be required 2, and the maximum is confirmed up to 50 only. Apart from that, any private limited company should be mentioned in its name as private limited, or within the brackets PVT or P, means it is a private limited company. Right? And here, the private limited company do not have any access to the common public for subscription of the share, right? So that's why it is called as a private limited company. Next one is government company. A company which is wholly and solely subscribed to the capital, invested, maintained and controlled by the government, maybe a state government or the central government or the combination of both state and central governments. In anywhere, in the case of India or anywhere, when once a company is being formulated, maintained and controlled and the business activities are conducted wholly and solely by the government, will be called as a government company. Here, the government is going to conduct the business in the form of company, form of business structure. In the case of 1956 industrial policy, if we go once again back to the industrial policy 1956, the 1956 industrial policy has clear-cutly mentioned in its industrial policy as the companies categorized into three categories: Schedule A companies, Schedule B companies and Schedule C companies. Schedule A companies are fully owned by and managed by and controlled by and business activities are conducted by the central government only. Schedule B companies are fully owned by, managed by and controlled by both central and state governments. And the Schedule C companies have been coming from the private sector. So, according to that also, we will come to a conclusion that any company which is being formulated by the government, controlled, managed and business activities have been continued by the government will be coming to be known as government company. Today we observe so many government companies. Indian Railways, what is it? BSNL, what is it? So many other, ONGC, even though they have been named as corporations, but they have been set up fully owned by the government only. Okay, after 1991, there may be a great change in the economic policy of the country and there may be a foreign direct investment or disinvestment or partial privatization. But whatever it may be, the main ownership is vested with the government only. Henceforth, the government companies are those companies which were set up, monitored, managed and organized by the government only. Next one is autonomous company. A company is a autonomous body where it is being constituted and it is maintained by the autonomous company as a body. Each such a company is called as autonomous company. For example, after 1991, most of the business organizations which were started in the second 5-year plan as public sector units have been transformed into autonomous companies. Here, the government has left its control and the entire control has been put in the hands of the board of council being nominated or being designated for the management of the company. I will give you an example here. There is a public sector unit, Bharat Heavy Plates and Vessels, BHPV, which has been initiated during the second 5-year plan after 1956. And latter course of time, what happens? The BHPV, Bharat Heavy Plates and Vessels company has been went into huge doldrums in the area of 1990s and before 2000. Well, once what happened? The government has taken a decision and asked the BHPV to function on its own business lines for acquiring revenue, for meeting the expenses and so on and so forth. Automatically, the government company has been transformed into a autonomous company or a corporation, like that ONGC, like that so many other companies which have been now functioning as a corporate with an autonomous body of its management, right? So henceforth, autonomous companies are to have fully autonomous controlled body and they will go for maintenance and formation of its own actions and activities. Next one is a company which is called as chartered company. What is a chartered company? A company which has been constituted or formulated basing upon the charter or the governmental order by the king or a queen of a country is called as a chartered company. Means according to the charter or the gazette of a country, if a company has been created, formulated, constituted and being maintained and controlled, such type of companies are called as chartered companies. In India, we do not have any chartered companies mostly. But in the case of UK, in the case of Australia, in the case of some other countries, where there was still the rule of a king or a queen is existing, there we can find chartered companies. Next one is one person company. It's a new creation as far as the Indian Companies Act 2013 is concerned. A person can create a company by following the norms prescribed in the Indian Companies Act 2013. So based upon that, if a company has been created by single person, being managed and controlled, is called as one person company. Next one is a holding company. Then what is a holding company? Here, the company which holds the percentage of the total share capital is called as holding company. For example, I will tell you, for example, there are two companies, company A and company B. For example, the total capital is 100%. If A company acquires or maintains or holds 51% of the total capital and the remaining 49% is left in the hands of the B company and acquires B company B by A, then A company is denoted to be 51% means holding company, and B company with a minor share of capital existing is called as a subsidiary company. When once there is a holding, automatically the overall control of B company is vested with the A company. Means the holding company will have a major decision maker and having a controller and maintainer of the B company's activities also apart from the A company's its own existence. Henceforth, a holding company is a company which have at least minimum 51% or more than 51% of the shares acquired of the other company is called as holding company. And the remaining company or the other company where a minimum of 49% or less than 49% of the share capital existing will be called as a subsidiary company. And the subsidiary company is supposed to be governed by the holding company in the future course of time. This is what some of the different types of the companies, what we can have an overall view when we go for the understanding of the conceptual knowledge regarding the types of companies today what we have. Apart from that, there are more changes across the globe and so many other forms of companies may do exist. It is suggested to you to go for an overall view of a detailed review of various types of companies which were existing as on today as far as the company form of business organization is concerned. Thank you very much. Okay, if you have any doubts, please clarify in later.